Hello everyone, welcome to the second preview video for the Vizier milestone for Wano, which brings us to new nations, and we already looked at the French division. If you haven't seen that video, you can find it down in the description below or up in the corner right now. And the second division we get and the second nation are the Brits. The Brits are finally here with the first armored division of the Royal Army, and it brings in some really cool stuff. Before we go in here though, one more shout out that if you want to test all these new divisions and the new patch in action, you can do so on Friday, as we have the second Friday night of Wano 2v2 tournament coming up. And the cool thing about these events is that, first of all, it's a chilled single elimination tournament, but also we will be joined once more by Eugen Damned, and this time also Eugen Panzer. So, two of the Eugen devs, to talk about the game and just talk about the development, having a bit of banter with them, and maybe asking some questions about the future of, in a bit of a Q&A segments as well, about what is to come for Eugen, for Wano. And if you're interested in that, tune in on Friday or watch the VOD later on YouTube. But yeah, live on Twitch on Friday with this event. So looking forward to see you there. And with that, let's move on into the British First Armored Division. In the recon tab, we don't have, in the logistics tab, we don't have too much special, but what we got here is pretty decent. We got a Bedford supply truck with good amounts of supply, a Chinook supply truck with 2,500 supply, FV432 command, as another CV for 100 points, with 3 availability, light armored, relatively slow. The Sultan with a bit of better armor, slightly better off-road speed, but also 10 points more expensive. And then the Rover CP has your basic CV Jeep, unarmored, but 4 availability and good speed to get where it needs to be. So pretty nice vehicle here. Then, in the infantry, we have a couple to cover, as the first ones are the RMPs, four-man squad with a medium machine gun, and a battle rifle, and one SMG. So, as many different weapons as possible you can carry on a four-man squad coming in a Rover. Decent fire support, I guess, for other squadrons with the medium machine gun. The battle rifles and the machine guns, too few to really help out with any significant amount of damage when coming on on their own. But they come at least with relatively high veterancy. If you get enough of them, they, I guess, might be able to do something. The military police. So, yeah. A unit that otherwise is just there to hold the line and see where, if enemy movement is coming into their sector and shooting them a bit, and maybe dealing a slight bit of damage. Then you have the gun group, which has two LMGs, so really a fire support unit, and it has interesting transport options as well. The first one is the FV432 with a 7mm MG. Pretty bad speed. The Rover, or the FV510 Warrior with its 30mm Rodden gun. Or and an MG, decent armor, solid 20mm, 30mm autocannon, with solid range and damage, so pretty helpful vehicle as well, and could be worthwhile bringing. It's maybe the cheapest version. You can't bring these warriors in, like you have to bring the infantry unit around again, and like just carry this cheap infantry unit if you just want the warriors. And the infantry unit, I mean, yeah, it's not doing much on its own, as it will die quickly, but as a support unit, it's pretty nice with its two MGs and an L85 are there to help out a bit as well, I guess. Two Milans, then the Milan 1 and the Milan 2 as your classic European Army ATGMs. This time, the ATGM vehicle that comes with you is the Spartan MCT. It has two tubes. I'm not quite sure if that plays a massive role though. It has Hybrid of Fire, it says, but I don't know if it can shoot two at the same time. That would be fancy. I didn't test this too much. Has Smoke though, for 40 point unit, pretty nice. But I haven't really tested how the ATGM works here. As Hybrid of Fire doesn't matter too much for most ATGMs, as they can fire once their missile has hit the target anyways. Then you have your Rifle Leaders. With a Law and 6-man squad with L85s and a Mac Warrior or FV-432 as the transport options. Armed rifles that come with a Law as well. Two LMGs, so pretty solid firepower. Only 7-man though, and the classic assault rifle as well. And they can come in a Warrior with a Milan. Milan 1 on these, so not the most amazing ATGM, but a decent one at and for 10 points more. And then the normal rifles that come with 8 hit points and a Law 80 as the ATGM. Pretty good ATGM, somewhat similar to the Apilas, just one penetration less. Other than that, the stats are equal. And the Apilas is doing a good job with the French, so I wouldn't expect this one to perform pretty well as well. The transport options here are limited to the Bedford or the FV. I personally would actually go with the Bedford just for the extra speed. And then Assault Pioneers. Though the price is Bedford's now 20 points, just like the Rovers. Video about all the changes coming as well. Assault Pioneers and Assault Pioneers Carl Gustavs. Pretty standard as well. Assault Pioneers coming with the TNT. No flamethrower unit here for the French is... for the British is... interesting. That might be a problem for town fights, but at least you get two cards of the normal Assault Pioneers with TNT to help you out with that a bit. Two LMGs here on these units as well. So a lot of LMGs flying around on the British units. Basically the only ones that don't get two LMGs are the military police and the leaders, but they still get more LMGs than they get in other nations. So British, pretty LMG heavy. And then the Assault Pioneer leader with 6 SMGs of the L2AR. Pretty bad LMG compared to the German ones. Still helpful in CQC, as it's supposed to be with an Assault Pioneer. Transport option here, rather limited as well though. So yeah, infantry tab, decent but not the most amazing ever. And you also are obviously limited in slots as this is an armored division. So yeah, you need to be careful. Artillery tab, you have a couple of options. Starting with the classic mortar, 81mm mortar in this case. And 81mm in the FV. And then FV-433 artillery option. Your small self-propelled artillery with 105mm. Pretty cheap though. And good availability as well. Your slots here are decent, not amazing. And then the classic NATO M109 and the Faltobitze 155mm, the German gun here. The Abbott could be interesting though. I wonder how good this thing will perform for 130 points. Should be pretty decent. Relatively small gun, but yeah, rate of fire is decent as well, and you get good availability and price for this one. Though the armor is rather low, so it's not protecting you too much against enemy damage either. But you're somewhat fast and you have some armor. Tanks is obviously where this deck excels in, and British tanks are quite interesting. Starting with a Centurion Mark V AVRE. The AVREs are back in business, guys. Just like in Steel Division. This time on the Centurion though. 165mm gun. 3.6 HE damage, so dealing a lot of damage per hit. Having decent range compared to the French howitzer gun. This one is pretty close to the American one, I would say, in stats as well. 95 points. Speed, obviously rather low. Mediocre optics, so not seeing too much on its own either. And then you get your ATGM carriers, both using the Swingfire ATGM. One has the FV-938 with this string fire on top, and the other is the Striker that we already have seen with one of the German divisions in form of the Belgian one. String fire, decent penetration, decent range. Accuracy is on the low end though, that's the issue here with this ATGM. Yeah, you will have to see which one you take. I'm not quite sure why you should take this one though. Yeah, maybe there's something that still is missing in the stats, because this one is 15 points more expensive, but this vehicle just seems better. So yeah, we will see what is going to change there. And then you got your chieftains and your challengers, and the chieftain comes in with the classic 120mm that you have on all of these tanks, with 19 penetration, 20 frontal armor, 15 frontal armor, sorry, slow speed as per usual with the British tanks, not the fastest boys on the battlefield, but 19 penetration and 2275 meter range with also pretty decent accuracy is quite strong. You also have a stabilizer unlike the French tanks, so you can move and shoot whilst you slowly advance forward. This stabilizer is pretty powerful here, and yeah, you can take some damage. The Chieftain Mach 9, the disadvantage it has is slightly less range compared to the Mach 11, that is also the command version. And yeah, accuracy wise, they are otherwise equal, but yeah, the big differentiator is the range. That also means more penetration for the Mach 11 on the same range. So Mach 11 has 2 more penetration on the 2100 meter, and then we have 1 more penetration, so that's quite a difference there as well. That's why this one is more expensive, the extra range and the extra penetration. And then you get the Challenger, which is slightly faster and especially is quite more heavily armored. 20 frontal armor is really powerful. Top armor is only 3. I am still hoping for another 4 top armor tank, but all of these are 3 as well, as only the Abrams HA seems to be the one with seems to be a tank with 4 top armor that saves it from cluster quite a lot. So these a bit more vulnerable to cluster, still having the same gun here, though they have slightly better accuracy. Yeah, rate of fire on these guns also slightly higher for the Challenger, so all around just a better tank than the Chieftain by a lot of metrics. The frontal armor though being the biggest one, but more accuracy and rate of fire also pretty helpful. No auto loader on these, so they will get reduced rate of fire if they get stressed out, so you have to be a bit careful there. Challenger coming with a lot less availability and also obviously being quite a bit more expensive, but in general good guns here on the British tanks, and solid armor. Only issue is the speed a bit, and that you don't have a cheap tank option in this, in these decks, but that's what your warriors are for, and I guess the Centurion can help out as an infantry support tank. And then you have a couple more options for light armor in the recon tab as well, where you start with the Ferret. Yeah, classic Ferret, recon scout car, good optics, LMG, that's it, good speed, just running around trying to get some intel. Has smoke, so that's one nice feature there. And then the FV-721 Fox with a 30mm Raiden on a really fast vehicle, 99 km/h off-road is insane speed, so these things could have some annoying meme potential, as they can just race through open fields and forests. So these I could see being used in some interesting memes. And then the Scorpion and Scimitars we already know from the Belgian units in 2nd Panzer Grenadier. SAS Patrol with a lore, so your classic recon unit for MPs. MP, pretty good SMG. And then you can bring them in Gazelles, unlike the French recon transport helicopters. These don't have very good optics though, so the Gazelle here is the one with very good optics, the recon version. Green Archer, your exceptional optics, recon vehicle. And then you got your scout with the lore 80, ATGM, that you also can bring in Spartans or in Lynx. And then your normal scouts, same transport options, with the normal lore though, for 5 points cheaper and with better availability. I would say the SAS patrol is slightly better. Issue here is that they only have 4 availability versus 9 availability, so that's an interesting decision to make. And I guess, yeah. But I guess on highest frequency, the SAS still has more. Interesting, as they are so much cheaper and they still have the same lore. Just obviously they don't have the LMG. Yep. AA wise, you're rather hamstruck, as two of your options are javelins. One is the classic javelin. Not the most amazing man pet, only 4 damage, really low accuracy, decent range at least, but really not something you want to rely on fully for your AA. And the other one is the javelin LML. This one fires in salvos of 3, so at least you will hit the enemy at once with 3 of the shots, but still the problem of being a mediocre damage and accuracy weapon. And then the tractor up here, which at least is a pretty decent AA vehicle, and you get 2 cards of 6 of these. Decent accuracy and really good anti-helicopter range. Only the anti-aircraft range is a bit nasty, annoying, but with 6 HE you also 2-shot every helicopter, you 2-shot 1 armor planes, and so pretty helpful here as well. And a solid rate of fire. So the rep here is your a vehicle that you really want to use, and the javelins are then the support on the front line. Really wondering how effective the LML will be with its salvo fire. I doubt it will be too amazing, but we will see. Could be maybe better than you expect. Something that needs testing for sure. And then in the helicopter department, you get gazelles and you get Lynx. The gazelles come in with rockets this time. So a really cheap, really low rocket helicopter. 68mm, also not the biggest rockets ever, but could be fun to use. Just flying in, shooting, running back home. And then you get the Lynx Hellarm with TOW, not ITO, not TOW2, TOW ATGMs with only 16 penetration and only 50 accuracy, but still decent range. And then the ITO with better accuracy and obviously quite better penetration as well with 20 AP, though you also pay quite a bit more for these Lynx AH7 Hellarms. Airtrap is what you would expect from British. You get Harriers, Jaguars, and Tornadoes. The Harriers are your cluster carriers in this one, or you can use a Tornado one for this as well, though this one is really expensive. It carries a lot of cluster as well, but it's also really expensive. Then Harrier with HE bombs for 500 kilogram bombs for this price is quite nice, but obviously Harrier is really slow. Jaguar as rocket version, decent speed, has some AA capabilities as well. The Hydra rockets coming in, though, yep, relatively expensive for a rocket plane. The Jaguar with HE, also relatively expensive. Pretty good plane though, the Jaguar in general. 30 ACM, also decent. Harrier only has 20. Tornado has 30 as well. The Tornado AA is something we already know. 4 Sky Flashes, or do we? Yeah, I think we know this already, right? I think the British Air Superiority Fighter you get in the 2nd Panzer Grenadier has the same loadout. Maybe it's different. It's a Tornado AA for sure as well, but maybe it has less Sky Flashes. Like, 4 Sky Flashes is pretty powerful. You for sure can kill an enemy plane on long range with this. And if you then go to short range, you still have 4 Sidewinders. So, yeah, pretty good plane. Decent, really good accuracy on the Sidewinders as well. Can kill helicopters quite efficiently as well. Then you get a Seed Tornado. This one we know already though. 3 alarm and a Sidewinder if you need it. And then Tornado HE and Tornado Cluster that we already had a look on. So yeah, a really cool deck. I'm really looking forward to see the challengers roaming the field. Especially, yeah, looking forward to Friday. Might just play the new two decks with Damned in the tournament. And yeah, looking forward to see you all there to see how good all of these work. And see you all in the ladder pool from tomorrow onward with these as well. Really cool looking deck. Can't wait to see the British in action. Wondering how strong they will be. I don't think they will be absolutely meta, but they will for sure have some power and some uniqueness to them in the play with their tanks, their heavy LMG infantry, and their pretty fancy recon tab. So, yeah. See you all there. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, consider subscribing and liking, and see you all next time.